Hey, welcome back, everybody. Approaching 6:44 right now. And how about this live image from Marquette, of course, in the Upper Peninsula. And they can have it, folks. A couple inches of snow. Lake enhanced, a lake effect, snow showers and squalls. We could do without that here. Approaching the middle of May and still getting snow in the Upper Peninsula. You know, we've been talking about the prospect for even a flurry around here today. That's not impossible, but certainly we are not going to be turning the ground white here in West Michigan. Thank goodness. Upper 30s we have from Muskegon southward to Holland and South Haven. Benton Harbor at 40 degrees. Grand Rapids in the middle 30s. I will say, though, when you step outside, boy, it has a wintry just a type of smell and feel. It definitely has that type of an appearance here this morning with some additional clouds around, perhaps some frost there, Fremont over to Big Rapids, but the vast majority of us kind of dodging that here early today. We will not, though, tomorrow morning, as temperatures will be dropping into the upper 20s for a lot of us, and even the mid-20s for some rural areas to start about 24 hours from now. A northeast breeze or a north breeze around 10 to 15 miles per hour, 35 degrees, we'll call it on average at 7 a.m., move towards 41 and 46 degrees here for a daytime high in GR. So that is officially 21 degrees below normal for this time of year. 67 is where we should be. And by the end of the 7-day period, once we get to later next week, our average high is going to be right about 70 degrees. We haven't seen much of that this year thus far. A freeze warning for later on tonight officially goes into effect at 11 p.m. and lasts until 9 a.m. on Saturday morning. Of course, tomorrow morning, scattered showers likely on Sunday. We'll talk more about that coming up. And then warmer late next week. Keyword, late next week. We will slowly start to gain some momentum early next work week and then get closer to 60, say, by Wednesday, Thursday, and then probably near 70 degrees by next weekend. You can see all these counties here across the Midwest, even the Ohio Valley, the Tennessee Valley, picking up on freeze warnings for the overnight tonight, and just a closer look at it. Frost expected and a freeze expected, and in some cases a hard freeze anticipated. Now, if there is going to be a spot within our viewing area that may kind of dodge the freeze to a large degree, it could be right along the immediate shoreline where some influence from those modified waters or that air modification could keep you around 32 to 34 degrees for an overnight low. But the vast majority of us will be down in the upper 20s. There's the Lakeshore Flood Advisories for today. Start at 11 a.m. and go until early tomorrow morning. A Lakeshore Flood Warning, in fact, with real the trajectories that are coming right in towards Berrien County this afternoon. So waves around 8 to 10 feet, perhaps size 11 or 12 feet near the St. Joseph area. We widen the scope. And yes, a few flurries here into the thumb of Michigan. We may creep a flurry or two here locally later this morning, maybe a sprinkle as the boundary layer temperatures get a little bit too marginal for any snowflake activity. Nonetheless, it's a possibility, folks. Nothing dramatic going on. And this system over the province of Alberta showing some green colors there. That'll dive southward and kind of serve as an Alberta clipper type of a system that'll bring us showers by Sunday. One weather system moving to our south. We had shown you that yesterday morning. That was going to completely miss us, but we are on the north side of that and tugging down some Canadian very, very cool air for this time of year. And you know, what's interesting is that with all the talk of a warming climate and whatnot, it seems like these springs, by and large, have been getting chillier and chillier, and this warming climate perhaps causing some of these wavy jet stream patterns and this big trough to dig into the eastern U.S. in recent years. So that's something to something to keep in mind, and we'll see if they do some studies on that or whatnot. But nonetheless, it is cool into late next week, eventually I think closer to 70 by next weekend.